I gave you something most mortals never experience. A second chance at life. And now all you can do is complain?
I can't live out my days as that person. That man is bereft of passion and imagination. That is not who I am.
Au contraire, he's the person you wanted to be. One who was less arrogant and undisciplined in his youth. One who was less like me. The Jean-Luc Picard you wanted to be, the one who did not fight the Nausicaan, had quite a different career from the one you remember. That Picard never had a brush with death, never came face to face with his own mortality, never realized how fragile life is or how important each moment must be. So his life never came into focus. He drifted through much of his career with no plan or agenda, going from one assignment to the next, never seizing the opportunities that presented themselves. He never led the away team on Milica 3 to save the ambassador, or take charge of the Stargazer's bridge when its captain was killed, and no one ever offered him a command. He learned to play it safe, and he never, ever got noticed by anyone.
You're right, Q. You gave me the chance to change, and I took the opportunity. But I admit now, it was a mistake.
Are you asking me for something, Jean-Luc?
Give me a chance to put things back the way they were before.
Before you died in sickbay. Is that what you want?
I would rather die as the man I was than live the life I just saw.
End this.
Moi? What makes you think I'm either inclined or capable to terminate this encounter?
If we all die here, now, you will not be able to gloat. You wanted to frighten us. We're frightened. You wanted to show us that we were inadequate for the moment. I grant that. You wanted me to say, I need you.
I need you!
Position?
070, Mark 6-3, sir.
Back where we started.
That was a difficult admission. Another man would have been humiliated to say those words. Another man would have rather died than ask for help.
I understand what you've done here, Q. But I think the lesson could have been learned without the loss of 18 members of my crew.
If you can't take a little bloody nose, maybe you ought to go back home and crawl under your bed. It's not safe out here. It's wondrous, with treasures to satiate desires both subtle and gross. But it's not for the timid. The Continuum didn't think you had it in you, Jean-Luc. But I knew you did.
Saying that it worked. We collapsed the anomaly.
Is that all this meant to you? Just another spatial anomaly, just another day at the office?
Did it work?
Well, you're here, aren't you? You're talking to me, aren't you?
What about my crew?
The anomaly, my ship, my crew. I suppose you're worried about your fish, too. But if it puts your mind at ease, you've saved humanity once again.
Thank you.
For what?
You had a hand in helping me get out of this.
I was the one that got you into it. A directive from the Continuum. The part about the helping hand, though, was my idea.
I sincerely hope that this is the last time that I find myself here.
You just don't get it, do you, Jean-Luc? The trial never ends. We wanted to see if you had the ability to expand your mind and your horizons. And for one brief moment, you did.
When I realized the paradox.
Exactly. For that one fraction of a second, you were open to options you had never considered. That is the exploration that awaits you. Not mapping stars and studying nebula, but charting the unknown possibilities of existence.
Q, what is it that you're trying to tell me?
You'll find out. In any case, I'll be watching. And if you're very lucky, I'll drop by to say hello from time to time. See you later.